Welcome to Varsity. I'm Ryan Aber, joined by Jason Kersey. We're here to talk about the Class 3A State Championship game, 7:30 p.m. Friday night at Boonpickin Stadium in Stillwater between Anadarko and not Heritage Hall, Cascia Hall, pulled off a huge upset last week on the backs of its defense, the Blue Swarm.
Yeah, Cascia Hall's defense was able to just completely shut down Heritage Hall's offense, especially the passing game. They were able to take away a lot of the weapons that Quinn Chambord has had all year. Of course, Sterling Shepard was hurt, to be fair. He had suffered a calf injury the week before, but he did drop three passes, and they just played really, really well on defense.
And we hear about Cascia Hall's defense a lot. No player stands out more than Connor Sherwood and the job he's done this year. What is it that has made him so effective?
Well, he's just a great linebacker, and he's joined by other great players as well. You know, Cascia Hall's got playmakers all over the field. And like I said, their secondary really stood out because they were able to limit that very effective Heritage Hall pass game.
And we looked at Anadarko's offense all year and how they would match up against Heritage Hall's defense. Mm-hmm. You look at Sheldon Wilson and the numbers he's put up. Right. Obviously, that's a different dynamic than what Heritage Hall threw at him last week. How do you see that playing out?
Well, you know, Barry Sanders still had 100 yards last week, but they were able to stuff him on the one-yard line to seal the game, so they can stop the run. Sheldon is one of the most dynamic players in the state. We all know that. But I don't know how he'll be able to do. You know, we've said all year he's got all these great numbers, but they haven't really played anybody. Well, then he did it to Kingfisher, and he did it to Metro Christian, and he did it to Berryhill. So he's been able to do it to good defenses, but he hasn't seen one like this.
Definitely. And then you go to the other side of the ball. Cash's offense matching up against Anadarko's defense. One of the things that we worried about all year with Anadarko when they got to this point, if they got to this point, was how they would match up with Heritage Hall's wide receivers. Mm-hmm. Well, that dynamic gets taken off the plate with Cascia Hall. Is this a better matchup for them on this side of the ball exclusively than it would have been with Heritage?
You know, I think it is. Cascia Hall has two great running backs, and they are able to throw the ball when they have to, but they don't have anybody like Sterling Shepard. And you know, last year that's what kind of bit Anadarko in the playoffs was their inability to stop the pass. This year they got past Metro Christian, but you're exactly right. You know, Cascia Hall doesn't have a playmaking receiver at the level of Sterling Shepard, no.
And who are you picking in this game?
I'm going to go Anadarko. I don't think they're going to score as many points as they've been able to all year. I think I'm going to go about 21-17. I think they'll be able to score enough points, and I think their defense will be able to hold them to just the right amount.
And I think I'm going to go Anadarko as well. A little bit higher scoring, but not much than Jason. I think right about 28-24 in that neighborhood. I think now what I see is Anadarko, if they're going to win, it's probably going to be close. Now, I could see Cascia winning this game going away a little bit, but I think the more likely scenario is Sheldon Wilson putting up, not the kind of numbers he has all year, but still putting up really good numbers and coming out on top of this game. Mm-hmm. Jason, thanks for joining us, and thank you. Check us out every day at newsok.com/varsity for the best high school coverage anywhere.